What my bad bitches
say? I'm pretty than a motherfucker. Hoss be looking okay. She thinking that she fucking with me. Is this bitch okay? He said he ain't fucking around. I look at him like, okay. I used to be down bad, but now a bitch okay.
Yes, let's get into this makeup tutorial. As you can see, the makeup is sitting, guys. This is a very easy makeup tutorial. So yes, love the way the makeup turned out. This is my everyday go-to makeup, so you can definitely wear this every day, all day, nighttime, whatever, child. Here's me in a different lighting. Look at this, bomb, still bomb. The makeup is sitting, like I told you before. These are my techniques. I have very simple techniques on how to do your makeup. These makeup techniques only require you to use your fingers. So if you are not familiar with makeup, or you have a hard time using brushes, sponges, this is the makeup tutorial for you. Let's start off with, first of all, our skincare. So important. I love to share with you my skincare routine. I'm gonna start with a vitamin C serum. This one here I got at Target, but I'm going to go ahead and leave it in the description box below. Definitely works. So I'm letting the vitamin C absorb in my skin. So I give that a second. Yes. And then we get into the moisturizer. Love this moisturizer by Belief. I have very dry skin, so this is very hydrating. Love this. And I'm telling you, it gets the job done. When I'm telling you, skincare is damn near complete. So I'm gonna go in with this lip plumper by Dennis. I think it's Dr. Dennis. Nevertheless, I'll have it in the description box below. I got this from Sephora. Best lip plumper. It's quite expensive, but if you're not into lip injections, this is the one for you. So skincare is complete, as you can see. I'm just letting that absorb in my skin. I'm giving it a couple of minutes, maybe a couple of seconds, and it's on to the eyelashes. This is an easy eyelash application hack that I learned, because I was the last person to the party when it came to eyelashes. I just didn't know how to do it, and I fumbled with that black eyelash glue for a minute until I found out that the clear eyelash glue is really my friend, and it really is the goat when it comes to, you know, people learning how to do their eyelashes. So yes, this saves me time, and I don't have to worry about messing up my eyelashes with that black glue. When I tell you, it's flawless. Yes. So I don't really like, I'm not that person that really likes the little line, the black line. You know, I like it. It just looks like I have eyelash extensions on with this glue. So dry is clear. Don't worry about the white stuff. That stuff is going to clear in just a minute. Now we're on to the eyebrows, which is, people, you know, these are not twins, they're sisters, so they're not supposed to look alike. Now remind you, I did not dermaplane my skin, neither did I. My eyebrows were not arched in this video. I'm telling you, if you have the right makeup technique, you can make anything look just fine. So yeah, we're gonna go in with these eyebrows, and like I said, we're not trying to make a magic, but we are trying to make them look good, because that's the end result. The end result is, when you put your makeup on, you want people to compliment on your makeup. You want people to say, oh, you look so pretty. Oh, your makeup is so pretty. That's what we're going for. And these techniques, these simple techniques, you can do. And like I said, it just takes a minute to get that eyebrow. You know, I don't want them looking crooked, but I'm not trying to get them straight. The goal is complimenting on my makeup at the end. So yeah, eyebrows were not even shaped. I'm shaping them as we go with the the concealer. So yes, I'm just shaping them, because I like to see, you know, I like my eyebrows kind of like how I'm doing them right now. And so yeah, once I get them shaped and get that concealer, you know, pretty much gone. And like I said, I'm using my fingers majority of this video, so I promise you, it's just as simple as that. These are just simple techniques that I've learned over the years, just by doing my makeup for so long. It don't take all that makeup brushes and expensive products and expensive skincare. It doesn't. I love this sunscreen by Supergoo. It is definitely the last step in my skincare routine. And as you can see, it will leave a white cast if you do not take your time and rub this stuff in. And like I said, you don't have to use this particular sunscreen or this skincare routine that I have. But if you do, I guarantee you, it's a game changer. That's why I always add the skincare when I'm doing my makeup, because it's so important. I hate when people just jump right into makeup. Like, what do we do before the makeup? The skin prep. So this is me playing with the light, y'all. I'm just, you know, dilly dabbling, trying to figure out what's the best lighting. The best lighting is the lighting that you've been doing. Like, this is fine. Leave the light alone. So as you can see, I pretty much used a good majority of that sunscreen, and I've wiped, and it's practically no white cast is what I'm trying to say. So yeah, we're gonna move on to the foundation. Boom. Look, I'm telling you, just a little dab, but do you? It don't take all that. You don't need all that makeup, because when you get up there and you get out in that sun, and it's just too much. So this is why some people overkill the foundation. They don't even need to. You see how I made that little foundation, and it don't even matter. Any foundation, whatever foundation you want, if you want low-end foundation or you want high-end foundation, drugstore foundation, who cares? Put a little bit of foundation, just a tad foundation on. It will make such a big difference. And these are my techniques that I've been using over the years, because sometimes overly doing your face will make you look older than what you are. Okay, and we don't want that. We're gonna go in with the hourglass stick. This is just I have like dings on my face, so I have like this you know, scar I'm trying to cover up. This is a perfect foundation stick to do that. So, you know, covering up a few kind of like scars. You really don't need to. I really don't do this part, but I did it today, so this is why I'm showing it to you, because this is how I did my makeup. Really don't need this step, but I do it. Get that, you know, mustache, the little shadow mustache, that works good for this. So yeah, I'm just, again, fingers for every application almost. So, and you, like I said, you really don't need a lot. You got your fingers, you got your makeup. This is what you need. This is the techniques that I use that are very simple, and I'm telling you, they get the job done. When I tell you, I get so many compliments on my skin routine, I get so many compliments on my skin, my makeup, they love it. And I appreciate all the girlies that say, oh, you look so pretty today, you look so nice, you know. And that makes me feel good, because I mean, literally, look at this flawless application. Here we go. This is how I literally brighten the eye. I don't use foundation, because like I said, all that heavy cakey makeup, that stuff will tell off on you in the sun, and nobody got time for that. I don't want my makeup to tell off on me in the sun, caked all up, because, you know, less is more. Okay, yes. And don't believe that men don't like women with makeup. That's a lie. Okay, we all know that's a lie, because as soon as we put it on, they're the first ones to turn around. Now I get a couple of, you know, likes, you know, when I don't have it, but yeah, it's a beautiful thing to make yourself feel good about yourself, and just makeup is just love it. So this gave me a very bright under eye, and you'll see once the makeup look is complete how I go about doing this. These steps are very important. I'm going in with the darker Kosas powder. This is the Kosas powder in both the lighter shade and the darker shade. This Kosas powder is great for people with dry skin. Dry skin is the perfect powder for you. So yeah, I love this powder. I'm going in to warm the face up with this powder, and this powder does the job. I mean, it's an excellent powder. Now we're gonna go in with the eyeshadows. I don't really do a lot with the eyeshadow, because it doesn't take all that. I just want a little highlight under the eye to, you know, highlight the emphasis of my, you know, brow that I carved out. That's it. You know what I'm saying? We don't need a whole lot. I don't want to do a whole lot, because this is my everyday makeup routine. So this is my everyday makeup, period. You know, I don't ever, you know, switch it up, because I don't need to. It just is perfect. Once you have a perfect formula, you don't want to switch it up. You just want to stick to what's working. And this was work. So I just apply a brown, just like a regular brown eyeshadow that matches, as you can see, my shoulder here. My favorite part is the bronzer, because this is the thing that brings everything together. The bronzer. If you don't have bronzer in your life, then what the heck are you doing? Like, where are you from? See how that bronzer just adds, you know, life back to the face? I'm telling you, it's the life of the party. You know what I'm saying? So this bronzer right here goes with my shoulders. You see how everything's coming together now? This powder 100% goes with my skin tone. So I like to pile this bronzer on, because if I don't, and I didn't, if I just walked out of here, and baby, face would look crazy. So I have this little thing that I do, which is called dry contouring effect. I simply just go down where I contour the nose, and it gives the effect of something, you know, my nose being contoured, because I lighted it, you know, with all that light powder. So I'm just going over it. Next, of course, the lip plumper has to go now, because I want to add a matte lip. And I love a red lip, especially when I'm browns like this in the summertime. It's just a pretty look. But yeah, it's important to get all that lip gloss off of the lips, because if you're going to wear a matte lip, it's not going to be matte if you do not take all this off. I'm doing this for a reason, so I can show you guys how plump the lips had gotten. The lips are plump, especially that top lip. I mean, it plumps the mess out of that top lip. She's a little expensive. This lip plumper is expensive, but she is worth it. And I'm telling you, I love the way this lip plumper looks. Look, let me freeze. Look at that. Look at that. Big lip. Love it. So yeah, after we go, lipstick time. Love this lipstick by Matt. Of course, you know it's the Ruby one. Ruby Woo. The OG one. So I love this. And I'm just doing this, you know, just barely. You know, I just like the way it looks. So of course it looks like an ombre look, but I'm not keeping it like that. I just like that. You know, that's for me to just, you know, say, do I want, you know, I'm just doing something right now. But yeah, again, we're going to move on to the darkening of the contour, because we already dry contoured. So it gave us a little contour, just a slight contour. But if you want to darken that contour up to make it a real, like, I just use a regular, you know, dark powder. And this one here is, I think I'm going to leave this one in the description box below too as well. This is the copper one. Love this powder as well. You know, it's very nice. Gives you a sun-kissed look. So yeah, see how I'm contouring that nose? It's a slight contour, because anything else, I don't like, you know. You can try it if you like to try a darker shade. That's your turn to do that. I'm going to reinforce this contour shade, because this really is what makes the look. Again, this, I've used nothing but powders, and I am a dry skin girly. So you can just imagine that this is not cakey. This does not make my skin feel tight, because we put everything together. Okay. We put the skincare application on along with our skincare. So we have nothing to worry about. Face is set. Face is beat. Let me show you guys how I maintain my quick weaves. And I have a quick weave tutorial. That was my last video, so you can check that video out after that. This is how I maintain that quick weave that I did in the last episode, the last video that I posted. So yeah, I got this thing from Walmart. Best thing ever. It just helps, you know, to maintain the curl, so I won't have to curl this packed hair every day, all day. I'm not the girly that's going to go around smelling like burnt hair, because I overly keep curling my hair. I'm going to get up every day and curl my hair. That's not going to be me. No, no. My hair has to be smelling good, just like I smell good. I don't want to lay down. My man does not want to lay next to me, and I have all this burnt hair smell. It's pathetic. Do not go to sleep next to your man with burnt hair, okay? And this is how we minimize not having burnt hair. We use something, this device here. And I'm just fluffing the curls out, because at this point, there's no telling how long I've had that bonnet on. Maybe 2 days straight. Okay, so I'm fluffing out the curls, trying to get it, you know, to look, you know, presentable. And that's what you're going to see me do. I'm fluffing it out to make the hair bigger. Meanwhile, never losing the curl pattern of this hair. It's beautiful. So again, we're going to go in with, of course, tiny baby hairs to complete this look, because this particular hairstyle will look good with tiny baby hairs. So this is what I'm going to do. So I'm going to use two of my favorite baby hair. I think I was out of one of the cans that I actually wanted to use. So this is me, you know, trying to get everything straight before I mold those baby hairs. And I like soft, fluffy baby hairs. I don't like all that stuck to my forehead type deal. Okay. So I'm going to go in with this toothbrush, because it was the softest brushes that I have. So I'm going to go in. I think I was out of the red can. I think I had a little bit got to be. So that's what we're going to use for this style. Like I said, I didn't even curl this. All I did was, as you see, sprayed a little bit of that got to be on the toothbrush and tucked them curls under for a soft, fluffy baby hair look. And I'm telling you, those curls, that baby hair lasts all day. Okay. And I'm going to just go ahead and do it on the other side, because this is essentially, it was a flip over quick weave method hairstyle. So I could wear it many of ways, but I tended to find that this particular hairstyle with a little slight of the tiny baby hairs was a good deal. I don't have to do too much with this hairstyle. It's very, very uncomplicated. And that's how I like my life. Very uncomplicated. Okay. Because who wants to fight with the baby hairs? You know what I'm saying? And who wants to damage and keep damaging, you know, your ends and your edges and things like that? That's not what we're here for. We're here for healthy hair. So yeah, this is the completed look in this particular light. And this light is giving. This light is saying, okay, yeah, we're ready. We're ready to go. We're ready to go shopping. We're ready to go get our day started. We just look too cute. This is the light. You know, the lighting is just perfect. So we got to make sure we're right, especially in this light and in the light, you know, I like to show you guys in the other light how this makeup is giving. And like I said, I use my fingers with half of this makeup. Love it. Love it. So yeah, we're loving this. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba. I'm loving it. So this is me in the different light. Okay. This is me in vlog action. Very simple routine. Anyone can do it. Anyone can do it. Because again, it was the simplest techniques. It's the technique. It's really not even the makeup, actually. Now, having and investing in good makeup will help you. It will. I'm not gonna lie. Investing in good makeup is going to make a difference in some of these makeup looks. But if you don't, you can use regular drugstore makeup to achieve this look. I'm telling you. You better find the right shade and get on it, because it's all about finding the right shade as well. Okay. So this is why I enjoy doing makeup, because it doesn't take me very long. It doesn't take me long at all. This makeup look that I'm going to get a lot of compliments on as soon as I go out the door, mainly from women. This is not even coming from men. You know, these women are like, yes. You know your makeup turned out okay if women are you know, giving you compliments. All right, guys, y'all stay up till the next time. Bye-bye.